The Datalogic Matrix 210 is an awesome little barcode imager that can handle both 1D and 2D barcodes. Instead of the traditional red laser beam scanning the barcode, it actually grabs an image of the barcode with a camera and analyzes that captured image to decode it. And the best news is, it's Ethernet IP compatible, so you can monitor and control it from an Automation Direct DuMore PLC. I have a DuMore PLC connected to a Stride Ethernet switch, which is connected to the Matrix imager. I'm also using the Datalogic CBX500 breakout box as a simple way to connect power to the imager. Once you have the unit set up and calibrated, get this Datalogic utility called VisiSet. Connect to the Matrix 210, and under Device, get the device's current configuration. Make sure the Ethernet IP is enabled here. Make sure the operating modes are set up as shown here. And make sure you enable the codes you plan to use. We'll be using this code 128 in our examples. Send that to the unit, and you're ready to use Ethernet IP. If you have any questions about setting up the Matrix 210, call the folks at Datalogic. I found them very friendly and helpful. Now that we've configured the imager, we just set up the DuMore like we always do. I have a new project open, and I'm connected to the DuMore. We always start with the system configuration and work our way down this list. Under CPU, we can make sure that the DuMore's IP address is on the same subnet as the imager. If not, we can change it here. And the DuMore in this example is the client controlling the imager, which is the server. So we don't need to enable the DuMore as an Ethernet IP server. We're not adding any I/O to the DuMore, so there's nothing to do here. And we're only using the built-in Ethernet port, and we're not adding any new modules to the PLC, so there's nothing to do here. Under Device Configuration, we could use the built-in Ethernet IP device to talk to the Matrix 210, but it's always better to create a new DuMore device for each piece of hardware you want to talk to via Ethernet IP. That way, no DuMore device has to manage multiple TCP/IP connections, which would slow down your code. Let's create a new device. We want an Ethernet IP device, and we'll call our device a Matrix 210. Great. Now we have a DuMore device that will handle all of the low-level details of dealing with the imager, which means we don't have to worry about buffer management or handshaking or memory allocation or any of that stuff. The DuMore does all of that for us. We don't have any new I/O, and the Ethernet IP device we created doesn't use any heap structures for us to talk to, so we're done configuring the DuMore, and we're ready to talk to the Matrix 210 imager. To do that, we just grab an Ethernet IP instruction, drop it on a rung, and fill in the blanks. We want to use our new Matrix 210 device, and he's at this IP address. This is where we put the codes we use to talk to the Ethernet IP device. Where do you get the codes? Well, over in the Datalogic website, search for Matrix Ethernet IP User Guide. I got this list here. They're all the same, just pick one. This user guide lists all the things you can do with the imager via Ethernet IP. Let's do something simple for our first example. Let's get the vendor ID, which is always in the identity object. And here it is. Looks like we need class 1, instance 1, and attribute 1 to get the vendor ID. We want to get this information, and we'll do it on the leading edge of the ladder contact. We use these status bits, and we'll put the vendor ID in D1, and the number of bytes actually returned in D2. The vendor ID is an integer, so we expect a maximum of 2 bytes. Great, accept that, and add a contact to enable the instruction. Remember, we told the instruction to start on the rising edge of this contact, which is indicated by this triangle, so we don't need a rising edge contact here. Well, looks good to me. Let's accept all changes and write it out to the DuMore. Let's bring up a data view so we can control this, and add the contact and the result. Make sure we're running, enable status, and enable editing for the data view. If we toggle this contact, we get this 850, which according to the manual is the vendor ID. Perfect. Here's the sequence of events we need to get the barcode. First, we need to trigger the image. Then we need to wait a little while for the imager to do its thing. Then we read this item sequence number and a fragment sequence number, and then we write those back to the imager to acknowledge that we actually got the barcode. I went ahead and created this little get barcode program so you wouldn't have to wait while I typed all this stuff in. Let's take a look at that. In stage 0, we activate the message trigger. It's just the one Ethernet IP instruction talking to our Matrix 210 device at this IP address using these codes and issuing a write with bit 7 set in this variable. Bit 7 of this byte is what's going to trigger the imager. If that's successful, we jump to stage 10. If not, we jump to stage 99 and increment an error counter. Stage 10 releases the trigger, so it's the exact same instruction, except it sends this register, which has a 0 in it, to clear the trigger bit, and it jumps to stage 20 when it's done. In stage 20, we give the imager a little time to process the image. We start a timer and jump to stage 1 when the timer is done, which also shows that stages don't have to be in numerical order. In stage 1, we get the data into this string using these Ethernet IP attributes from the user guide, and then we jump to stage 2 when we're successful. In stage 2, we get the item sequence number into this memory location and jump to stage 3, where we get the fragment sequence number into this memory location and jump to stage 4. In stage 4, we write the item sequence number back to the imager using this set command, and in stage 5, we write the fragment sequence number back to the imager. Again, writing the sequence numbers back to the imager is what acknowledges the receipt of the data so the imager can process the next barcode. When done, we exit the program. Stage programming makes sequencing things like this so easy because it takes care of all the interlocking and transitions automatically. So all of these Ethernet IP instructions we used were pretty much the same, weren't they? We just look up the codes in the user guide for what we want to do and fill in the blanks. Back in the main program, we run that get barcode program on the rising edge of a contact. Accept all that and write it out to the Dumor. Let's add the new contact that triggers that program and the barcode result to our data view. Toggle the contact, and we get our barcode. Change the barcode, trigger another read, and we get the new result. Perfect. Now, this is by no means a complete example. There's a lot more information you can pull from the imager and use to your advantage, all of which is in that Ethernet IP manual. But for now, this ought to be enough to get you up and running. If you have any questions about using Ethernet IP on the Dumor, contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. Now, don't call them about Datalogic imagers or any other device Automation Direct doesn't currently have. They'll just send you to that vendor support, so save yourself a phone call. And check out the forums. That's another great place to get information from experienced and very helpful Dumor users. Spend less, do more with Automation Direct.